direction for good, for better, and even for you to experience the best of the moment. It's a divine solution to all the pandemic challenges. And God is here to give answers to all your problems. I welcome you. This is the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Lagos Province 30, Iba, Alsin Estate. Please invite your friends, invite your neighbors, invite as many people as possible to join you in this live broadcast. Shortly, the church choir, Jehoshaphat Choir, will be ministering to us in praise and worship, where you will dance and celebrate the glory of the Lord. And our daddy in the Lord, a man with special anointing for breaking yokes, who is here to bless you in the powerful word of God. Yokes shall be broken. God is here tonight and is here for you. And let your testimonies continue to roll in. From our previous editions, we'll be receiving testimonies, and I'm sure today the testimonies will be more. Our daddy is here, the pastor in charge of the province, Pastor Paul Olabode Emmanuel. The Lord will use him the way he has always been doing. Shall we close our eyes for the opening prayer? Our dear Lord, we thank you because you are our God. We thank you for everything you've done in past editions. We know tonight you're going to bless us. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We commit this program into your hand, Father. All the viewers at home and everyone you're going to use tonight, Father, we pray that you give us the unction to connect with the heavens in the name of Jesus. Thank you because you are here, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Let's invite the choir. God bless you.
Jesus, open and I am. Today.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We thank God for the new edition of this program. By the grace of God, last week was very great and the upper week was wonderful, and the Lord has been doing something remarkable in our life. I believe it shall be permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Today, we are going into the presence of God. I want you to join me to worship Him, the maker of our life, the Almighty God. We give glories to the Lord. He reigns. He reigns.
We give glories to the Lord.
He reigns. He reigns.
He reigns.
He reigns. We give glories to the Lord.
He reigns.
Hallelujah. We give glories to the Lord.
He reigns.
Hallelujah.
We give glories to the Lord.
Eternal Rock of Ages, the world from the beginning, we appreciate you for another opportunity that you have given to us to come to this Turning Point program. Today, we pray, as you speak your word to us, let your word bring a turning point to our life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let the power in your life break every yoke, destroy every yoke and burden of the enemy in our life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Those that are sorrowful, my Father, my God, give them joy.
Amen.
Those that are depressed, my Father, my God, give them good news.
Amen.
Everybody that is looking unto you, particularly at this season of this pandemic battle all over the world, my Father, my God, give everybody comfort.
Amen.
Those that are sick, Father, heal them today.
Amen.
In the battle of life, don't let us become stranded.
Amen.
Don't let us become victim. Teach us your word.
Amen.
Take total control.
Amen.
By the time you will be through with us today, let all of us, oh God, have the peace of God in our heart.
Amen.
With good testimony. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are welcome in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All our viewers at home, wherever you are, you have access to your Bible, pick your Bible, and let's go together in the Word of God. The topic says, when the battle is hot. When the battle is hot. When the battle is hot. I will read the Word of God. Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 10 to 13. Verse 10 to 13. At your own leisure time, you can read the entire Ephesians chapter 6, the entire chapter. Honestly, more miracle you will receive in Jesus' name. I read, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wile of the devil. For we wrestle not against the flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil days, and having done all, to stand. You will stand in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say you will stand in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Life is a battle. It's a battlefield. And the earlier we know, the better. For us in this world. Anybody that is in this world who does not know that he is already confronting a battle, may he not be a victim. And I pray you will not be a victim in Jesus' name.
Amen.
What is battle? Battle is every unpleasant situation of life. Every unpleasant situation is regarded as battle. Persecution is a battle. Hatred is a battle. Spiritual attack is a battle. Persecution, regular failure, sickness, disappointment, joblessness, just to mention few. But who are we fighting? Or who is fighting us? Who is fighting who? Those that are really fighting, the people that are facing the battle are human beings, the people of this world, the people in this world, you and I. But who are we really facing? The Bible says they are the devil, demons, principalities, powers, and rulers of darkness of this world in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. Although they use their wicked people, they use wicked people. Wicked people that submit to the devil. But by the grace of God, you will overcome.
Amen.
Why is the battle hot? Because I told us that when the battle is hot, if you look at what is going on in the world now, currently, all over the world, the news every day, you will be hearing that the number of the victims of pandemic is increasing, particularly in our nation, Nigeria. Brethren, it is battle. In a situation whereby the scientists and all the knowledgeable people, they could not find a solution, the battle is on. And the source of the battle is what I've already shown to you. But why is it hot? There's somebody that is a spirit being behind this battle. Although to some people they may look at it that what is he saying? What's all this one? But the Bible made us to know in that Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. But why is the battle so tense, so hot? The reason is to frustrate people, to frustrate, to make sure that, particularly we Christians now, to make sure that your relationship with God is cut off. To make sure that He still every good thing in you, later to kill you and to destroy you, according to the book of John chapter 10, verse 10. But I pray, in all this battle, you will overcome.
Amen.
I say you will prevail.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, what should be our approach? That's where we're going. Our approach to this battle. Should we just be looking? Should we just be reading news? Should we just be, be panicking? At this point in time, some people have separated themselves away far from God. Some people are tired. Some people are weak. Some people, now that we don't go to church, we are on at home. Some people are frustrated in their mind, and so on and so forth. But the Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 24, verse 10, that if thou faint in the days of adversity, your strength is small. Your strength is small. And that is what I want you that's what I want you to take and consider it seriously. And take a decision. And that decision should be that there is no going back. We are of the Lord. We are of the Lord. The Lord will save us. The Lord will deliver us.
Amen.
No retreat, no surrender. The power of the Lord will save us.
Amen.
Therefore, I want to give you three major approach. Our approach, particularly during this pandemic, if you want solution, because the whole world could not provide solution to what is going on now. But approach number one is this: as people of God, somebody that know God, like Nigeria, we should let our faith be hotter than the battle. The battle is hot. The battle is dangerous. The battle is disastrous. So also, we must increase our faith in our God. That is it. That is, you should go into the extreme of in your belief, like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. During their own lockdown, the king told them, "I will kill you." A faith that will never look back. A faith that is ready to give it what it takes, standing with God. In the book of Daniel chapter 3, verse 32 to 34, Daniel chapter 3, 32 to 34, these people decided, we will serve our God. They said, "King, whatever happens, we will not deny our faith." I don't know, as you are hearing me, I don't know your mindset. Whether you are derailed, whether you are tired, whether you are following what, all the rumors, all the polluted messages people are carrying all around that will increase your agony, pains, and trouble, whether that is what you are following. But I want to tell you that this is the time that you need to stand on your feet. You need to stand on your feet and believe your God and keep moving. It has happened before. And those people, that they're like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the people of the whole, they did not give up. And you will not give up in Jesus' name. Yeah. Number two, you need to serve the Lord with holiness. Your holiness must reach the peak now. Why? Your holiness, your righteousness must increase intentionally. Why? Because the plan of the devil is to pollute people. At this time, I remember when God told the children of Israel in the book of Exodus chapter 14. If you read verse 13 and 14 then, God told them, he said, "You will keep, Moses, go and tell my people that they should keep quiet and I will fight for them." Why? In the midst of lockdown, it is not easy. Some people will speak against government. Some people will speak against the ministers of God. Some people will speak against God himself. Some people will speak even against them themselves. But that one cannot bring solution. God told the children of Israel, and through Moses said, go and tell them that they should hold their peace so that they don't misfire. This time around, the word of God is coming to you that in holiness, if you don't know what to do, keep quiet. But by the grace of God, you will know what to do. Amen. You will not offend God.
Amen.
Number three, let your relationship with God be superb. Let your relationship with God be stronger. When the battle is hot, your relationship with God must also be stronger. You don't want to lose your head in the battle. This is not the time to be talking, mimic this and that and blame this and blame that one. In the midst of battle, everybody must face his life. And the Lord God Almighty that delivered the children of Israel will deliver the nation Nigeria.
Amen.
Will deliver those people that are hearing me.
Amen.
Will deliver me, deliver the whole world. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let your relationship with God be stronger than the battle. For instance, let your prayer be hotter. Your relationship with God in prayer. Pray in the night, pray in the day. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 18, if you read the book of Luke chapter 18 from verse 1 to 8, a woman was going constantly to a judge that, "Please avenge me. Jesus Christ, the one that gave the parable." He said, because the woman kept on, the persistence of the woman delivered her. She kept on going. And Jesus concluded, is that how will God not deliver his people that are praying unto him, crying unto him day and night? Brethren, our mistake, my mistake, your mistake, is that we complain, but we don't pray. Your relationship with prayer should be hotter. From today, the Lord will give you the grace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ,
amen.
Your prayer should be hotter. Your praise and worship also should be hotter. Should increase. Should increase. Worship God in the night. Worship God in the day. Worship God all the time. When you did this one, I'm telling you for sure, you and I, we will outlive the coronavirus.
Yeah.
We will outlive this pandemic.
Yeah.
We will outlive all these crises and problems.
Yeah.
And finally, let the word of God be hotter in your mouth. The word of God, make it hot in your mouth. Let the word of God be hotter. Speak the word of God with courage. You have the Bible. It's a weapon. You have the Bible. It's an authority. Brethren, it is time. I'm not saying we should not listen to news. I'm not saying we should not know what we should not be current. But let the word of God be more current in our brain, because the whole world is confused. The only thing that is not confused is the word of God. He says, I will be with you from now even to the uttermost part of the earth. Where is that one? Do you know it? Do you have it? I pray that the word of God will fill your mouth.
Amen.
I said the word of God will fill your mouth.
Amen.
In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are to, if you look at the word of God, if you read Ephesians chapter 6, verse 17, Ephesians chapter 6, verse 17, and you read Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. By the word you declare. If you declare you overcome, you overcome. If you say war unto you, you will perish. Today, I say you will overcome.
Amen.
I say you will overcome.
Amen.
In the precious name of Jesus.
Amen.
Believe the word of God, claim the word of God, say it in the day, in the morning, and by the grace of God, you will be among the people that will share testimony.
Amen.
It is well with you.
Amen.
I say it is well with you.
Amen.
Now, I want to pray. And the first set of people I'm going to pray for are those who have not given their life to Jesus. If you have not given your life to Jesus, please, wherever you are, say after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I commit my life to you. I surrender my life to you. Receive me into your hand. Save me. Forgive me all my sins. From today, continue to teach me and let your word abide with me. It shall be so in your life. In Jesus' name, I pray. So those of you that have given your life to Jesus, make sure that you find a living church and you continue to serve the Lord. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Now we are going to pray. We're going to have a short prayer, but I want this prayer to let us pray with all our heart, with all our strength. When the battle is hot, there's no time that the battle is hot than now. And that battle will not swallow you. You are going to say, my Father, my God, the battle that rages in the world, I resist the battle with the word of God. I resist you, battle. I resist you, all you confusion. In my life, in the name of Jesus, I resist you. I overcome you in the name of Jesus. I overcome you. I overcome you in the name of Jesus. I resist every battle. I declare myself a winner in the precious name of Jesus. Let's begin to pray. Let's begin to pray. Let's talk to Him. Let's talk to our God. I resist every battle in the name of Jesus. I overcome every battle, every situation that antagonizes, that confront my life in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. You are going to say, every weapon of war against me and my family be wasted. Every weapon of war. Every weapon of war facing, waging war against me and my family, be wasted in the name of Jesus. 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 Be wasted in the mighty name of Jesus. Every weapon of war fighting me, fighting my family, disturbing my life, be wasted. Every weapon of war in my office, in my family, in my body system, be wasted, be destroyed, be wasted, be destroyed, be wasted, be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Now say, Father, give me victory. Total victory in the battle of life. Total victory in the battle of life. Total victory. Total victory. Total victory in the battle of life. Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I pray for you in the name of God the Father,
amen.
God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. Every battle that confronts your life, battle in your home, battle in your life, battle in your place of work, battle in your family, battle in all your undertakings. Today, the name of the Lord, the power in the blood of Jesus, surmount them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your sorrow shall turn to joy.
Amen.
Peace of God will reign in your life.
Amen.
It shall be well with you.
Amen.
Whether the devil like it or not, we shall hear good news from you.
Amen.
Only good news in the name of God the Father,
amen.
God the Son, God, Holy Spirit,
amen.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Wow. I was so blessed today during the ministration of our daddy. And I'm
sure you are blessed too. Let your testimonies begin to roll in. This is an announcement. And we want you to join our weekly program. It's coming up again next week by the grace of God. And trust me, you will be blessed. You will be blessed. So many people have been giving testimonies, and the testimonies will continue to roll. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click on the subscription so that you can always get notification of our broadcast. And our Facebook timeline too. Please like our videos, share the videos, bless your friends. Bless everybody around you with the videos. Same with our Instagram page and our Twitter. You'll be getting different notifications of our post. So we also ask you to kindly tell everybody about this divine encounter that you have experienced today. If you check the screen, our pages are being displayed. Just log in and be blessed every week. This is offering time, and surely you'll be blessed. When the Lord blesses you, it is good that you give back in return. You are blessed already. As you give, your blessings will become multiplied. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can give online. Check the screen. You will see the account details of the Church of God. Give as a cheerful giver, and the Lord will bless you abundantly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We'll be dropping our offerings now. While those online too will give their offerings. Let's give our offering unto the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Alpha, Omega, Iwo ni mo fi yin fun o, Baba. Alpha, Omega, Iwo ni mo fi yin fun o, Baba. Please, for counseling and for prayer requests, can you call the numbers that are rolling on the screen? You will speak directly to the man of God, and your testimonies, you can equally share your testimonies via this number. God bless you. Father, we thank you for the offerings that have been brought into your presence. Thank you for providing for us. And thank you for the little we have been able to give unto you. Father, continue to bless us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Once again, it's my honor to invite our Daddy the Lord to give us final blessings. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I declare in the name of the Lord that your miracle shall be permanent.
Amen.
From today, your testimony will begin to come.
Amen.
As you are going, you will prosper.
Amen.
You will succeed.
Amen.
Enemy will bow before you.
Amen.
It, whatever you say shall come to pass.
Amen.
It is well with you.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name, I pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.